Hi, in this week, we shall continue the economic system. We established that economic system, talking about how resources are owned, managed, and controlled in an economy. We said in the previous video that it can be owned, managed, and controlled by private individuals, by the state, and by a joint ownership. If it is owned and controlled by private individuals, we call it capitalist. If it is owned and controlled by the state, we call it socialist. So today, we want to explain more what it means to have a socialist economist or socialism, which sometimes we refer to as centrally planned economy. Centrally planned economy. So, you can say that socialism can be defined as the type of economic system in which means of production and distribution are collectively owned and controlled by the state. So in this system of economics, the means of production and distribution, anything that has to do with the production and how the goods and services will be distributed to the consumers are collectively owned and controlled by the state or sometimes the government. So it is not private individual, but it is rather the state that is in charge of this particular aspect of the country. Then the major aim of a socialist economy is to produce goods and services for the general welfare of the citizens and not for profit maximization. So the main objective of a socialist economy is to produce goods and services for the general welfare of citizens and not for profit maximization. So you realize that this type of economic system aims at producing general goods or goods for the welfare of all the people. So when industries are set up under socialism, all that they do is to engage themselves in the production of goods and services that will take care of the welfare of the citizens and not for profit. So their aim is not to make profit. Their aim is to serve the need of the citizens in the economy. It is generally is the centrally planned economy in which there is no private ownership of means of production. So what we are saying here is that no private individual owns resources in this system of economy. Everything is owned, controlled by the government. So we have examples of countries which practice this system of economy. We have China, we have Slovakia, we have Romania, we have Poland, and other countries, Angola, Burkina Faso, Mozambique. There are some countries which engage in a socialism or centrally planned economy where resources are controlled by the government or the state. What are some of the features of this? There is a collective or joint decision making on what to produce, how to produce, and for whom to produce. So this is talking about the functions of the economic system, which are also functions of an entrepreneur, the one who join together the factors of production. So there is a joint or collective decision making when there is a need for production and how to produce, whom to produce, and what goods and services are to be produced. It is not a single person who makes that decision. Because it is owned by the state, there are a group of people who have been appointed to sit in a meeting to make a decision on this particular system of production. So there is a collective decision making or joint. There is a decision will be taken from different sources to put together to establish this kind of factory or this kind of production. Then there is also a state ownership of means of production. We have established from the definition that it is a state that owns all the resources that are used in the production process. And it is also a non-profit making motive. The motive and the objective behind a socialist economy or socialism is not to make profit, is to produce goods and services that will take care of the general welfare of the citizens in the economy. Then there is equal distribution of resources. Equal distribution of resources. Because of the motive of this system of economy, resources that are produced are evenly distributed to areas where there is a need for. So if resources are manufactured, they are not manufactured at only a particular place, so that they are not channeled to a particular consumer. They are evenly, as far as possible, evenly distributed to almost every part of the country where these goods and services will be in need. The idea is to cater for the general welfare of the citizens in the economy. Then there is also absence of economic rivalry. So in this case, we don't have anything like competition. This person is performing well than me, as it is in the capitalist, where different individuals are owning resources. That's why they are the sole, the state is the sole owner of all resources. The primary aim of socialism is to provide goods and services for the welfare of the citizen. So we have established that already in the in our definition, that the reason why a country can adopt a socialist is when the citizens lack the ability to produce for themselves or to take care of themselves. In this case, the state steps in, take over all the resources, make all productive decisions, produce goods and services, and then those goods and services are either given to the citizens for free or at the lowest cost. At the lowest cost or for free. This is because the state controlling the resource has no interest in making profit. So they give the goods and services to the people, and their motive at the end of the day is that the citizens in the economy will have their welfare or will have what they need. And these goods and services are given to almost everyone in the state who will be in it. It is not targeted to a specific area. So these are some of the features of a socialist economy, an economy where the means of production are controlled and managed by the state. All right, thank you.